Migration and climate change are both highly complex phenomena. In the public debate, we often hear about climate-related migration, or even climate refugees. And very often this is done with a note of alert. Let's have a look at what research says about this topic. First, there are various terms for people moving from home. Migration is only one of these, and not always the most applicable one. The concept of human mobility, as introduced by the UN Climate Secretariat, has proved to be more useful in various settings of people's movement, including the very complex and context-specific ones. So that is the term we want to use here. What are the drivers that make people leave their homes? There are five big factors affecting everyone's lives: the current political climate, the social, the economic, the environmental, and the demographic situation we are living in. Considerable changes in one or more of these topics can stress a person so much that he or she starts thinking of leaving home. Deciding to move is also heavily determined by the availability of jobs and accommodation or security prospects in destination areas. Mobility decisions, hence, are very complex and depend on many more factors. For example, how much money a person can raise, or how supportive his or her social network is. The effects of climate change, among many others, can be a considerable factor that makes people start thinking of leaving home. For example, in the dry areas of Greater Sahel, rainfalls have become unpredictable. Droughts are interrupted by short and heavy rainfalls. Small islands like the Comoros experience cyclones more often and more intensely. Large areas of the West African coast, as well as coastal areas in Europe, for example in Wales or the Netherlands, are threatened by the rise of sea level. Latin America is observing its loss of forests and glaciers. This is reality in many places of the world, threatening food, livelihood, and security, causing crop failures and declining yields. But does it really make hundreds of millions of people leave their homes? Human mobility has traditionally been part of the social organization and experience of people. Most mobility, the climate change related and the non-climate change related mobility, occurs within regions and not across far distances. Further, it is rather circular than permanent. People especially move from areas that additionally experience a weak or even fragile state, violent conflict, social tension, or in general harsh living or economically unfavorable conditions. Many people vulnerable to the effects of climate change try to cope by diversifying their income in the first place, instead of moving. Many households affected by climate change are so poor that they do not even have the necessary resources to move at all. They are trapped. They are hit at full tilt by the consequences of global warming. So, there are connections between climate change and mobility. But climate change is not the only reason for people to move. Labeling them as climate refugees is not doing them justice. Now, how can we achieve an evidence-based and more constructive debate? First, we need to change our perceptions. Human mobility has many different forms, contexts, and outcomes that can be positive and negative. There is rarely only one reason for people to move. Whether an environment is secure and feeding its population is more relevant than single incidents. Human mobility is an adaptation strategy. Second, human mobility needs to be governed in a more constructive and just way. Instead of preventing mobility and migration, states need to manage and regulate it. This includes strategies to avoid causes of distressed migration and displacement, as well as negative effects like human trafficking. We at the German Development Institute seek for solutions on how to bridge gaps between different policy fields, foster coherence, and create a common understanding of the challenges related to human mobility and immobility in the context of climate change, strengthen multi-level governance and local empowerment, make use of better databases and best practices to better understand the complex problems of local vulnerability and the role of human mobility. Changing attitudes and improving the governance of human mobility is not an easy task. It is a global task. And climate change, with its unpredictable dynamics, makes it even more urgent to deal with.